Top 10 Bizarre Accidents That Survived. Today we are going to talk about Top 10 Bizarre Accidents That Survived. Sometimes against all odds and in defiance of science, people manage to withstand experiences that really should have killed them. Take these 10 stories, for example, of people getting impaled, crushed, and literally blown up, and surviving to tell the tale. Here's the list of Top 10 Bizarre Accidents That Survived. But before starting the video, be sure to smash the like button and subscribe to never miss out on any of our videos. Number 10, a stick through the brain. Getting impaled through the brain is usually deadly because the brain controls all sorts of things we don't think about. Breathing, heartbeat, and blood pressure for one. Yet, in 1848, railroad worker Phineas Gage survived getting impaled by a 3.5-foot, 13-pound rod he was using to pack a hole with explosives. As the 25-year-old turned to greet coworkers, an explosion in the hole shot the heavy iron rod through Gage's jaw, brain, and skull, like this. Like a javelin, the rod landed several yards away. Unlike a javelin, it carried a bit of brain with it. Gage lived for another 12 years, saddled with a drooping eyelid, seizures, and dramatic emotional and cognitive problems. He remains a subject of medical fascination to this day. Number 9. Caught in an updraft. When 35-year-old paraglider Ira Wisniewska went for a practice glide in 2007, as storm clouds gathered above her, the result was an unscheduled flight across the Australian countryside in little more than the clothes she was wearing. High winds whisked her up 70 feet per second to just over 30,000 feet above ground and pushed her, frozen and bruised by hail reportedly the size of tennis balls, some 40 miles from where she started. Wisniewska fell unconscious during the flight, but came to after a while and steered herself out of the sky and onto a farm. Her main injury was frostbite. Number 8. Fourthman Muff nearly sawed off his own head. As a lifelong and enthusiastic lumberjack, it shouldn't be a surprise Fourthman Muff was still using his trusty chainsaw to chop down trees in his local area at the age of 74. However, in 1984, he suffered an accident that was almost impossible to survive. While he was out trimming trees, a branch fell and knocked him out, throwing him into a ditch. The fall broke his leg and knocked him out. When he finally regained consciousness, he found his still-running chainsaw was cutting through his neck. He stood up, positioned his head so blood wasn't running down his windpipe, and drove himself a half a mile to the neighbor's house. They went to the hospital 17 miles away, where doctors found he had sawn through his windpipe, esophagus, and jugular veins, leaving just the spine and some skin holding his head in place. Several surgeries later, Murph fully recovered and went on to live life for another 18 years. Number 7. Bouncy Castle Blast. Many of us hire bouncy castles for our kids' birthday parties, and children have a great fun time in it. DreamSpace V, a bouncy castle slash inflatable maze, was created to commemorate 10 years of the inflatable attractions business in 2006 during a London festival. Everyone was enjoying it when suddenly a strong wind came, the hinges of the castle got unhooked, and it made the entire castle to take flight up to 50 feet off air. It moved about 150 feet before coming back to the ground and had families trapped in it. Owing to this unfortunate accident, 13 people got injured and 2 died. Number 6. Forced through a small hole. Moving at high speed through a hole that's far smaller than your body can result in stripped skin, dislocated joints, broken bones, and crushed or punctured organs. That's what happened to welder Matthew Lowe in 2008 when his overalls got caught in a factory machine that transports metal parts. He felt his skin rip and heard his arm snap as the mechanism yanked him through a 5-inch opening, dragging him along the conveyor. The machine spat him out, screaming from the other end, with a broken back, pelvis, hips, and ribs, and a ruptured stomach and bowel. 6 operations and many metal pins later, the 25-year-old Lowe was back to work at the factory, hoping to get off the factory floor by training as a supervisor. Number 5. A dog shot a girl. A man from Jacksonville, Florida claimed that his dog shot his girlfriend. The couple was sleeping when they suddenly were woken up by their pooch, Diesel. The man allowed Diesel to go out to the bathroom, and when he returned, it is said that Diesel jumped on the nightstand in the dark bedroom where the girl was sleeping. As soon as the dog jumped, the man then saw a bang and a flash, and this was a gun that just discharged. His girlfriend was hit in her leg and suffered from non-life-threatening injuries. Each of these accidents is so strange, shocking, and hard to believe. Nonetheless, they are true, some fatal, and in some people were lucky to just have experienced a few injuries. Number 4. Anatoly Bugorsky was hit with a proton beam. In 1978, Russian physicist Anatoly Bugorsky was involved in an accident where a proton beam hit him in the head. the beam had sped up to almost the speed of light in a particle accelerator, similar to the one used at CERN as part of an experiment in Russia. Bugorski did not feel any pain at the time the proton beam hit, but did say he saw a light brighter than anything he had ever witnessed. It seemed like the physicist was incredibly lucky. Besides part of his face swelling up to twice its normal size, there were relatively few side effects. When the swelling went down, the left side of his face was paralyzed and he was deaf in his left ear. But he went on to live an almost completely normal life, and even completed his PhD. Number 3. Ron Hunt had an industrial drill forced through his skull. In 2003, Ron Hunt was a construction worker working in Truckee, California. As he was working on a job, his ladder suddenly gave way, sending Hunt and the drill he was holding down to the ground. Following standard practice, he attempted to throw the industrial power drill he was holding as far away as possible to avoid hitting it. Unfortunately, he didn't succeed, and his head clashed with the metal tool. By a miraculous stroke of luck, the drill didn't tear through his brain tissue, but instead pushed it aside. This meant there was no damage to his brain, but his eye was injured pretty badly. Surgeon took out the drill by unscrewing it from his eye. Number 2. The man with half a head. No, it's not a Photoshop. A police report about the incident involving this man quite literally describes him with the exact words, half a head. His name is Carlos Rodriguez, but for some strange reason, his friends and acquaintances call him Happy. Happy blames his unique appearance on a car accident caused by drinking and drugs, in which he hit a pole, was ejected through his windshield, and you can probably guess the rest. It's obvious that the other half of Happy's head ended up all over the road, but not so obvious is how the hell he's still here to tell us about it. Carlos said he had the accident at 14, but he and his unusual head only recently went viral. His mugshot was distributed online after an arrest for soliciting prostitution. In a video interview, Carlos had this advice for any reckless youth who may be watching. And this is how the old boy has come out. That is why it is not good, drinking and driving or drugness and driving. It is no good, kids. Number 1. The Killer Pigeon. One sunny day in 2010, Matthew Brealey was out riding his motorcycle with a friend near his Chesterfield home. Suddenly, while traveling at about 80 kilometers, 50 miles per hour, Matthew found his view obstructed by a low-flying pigeon that had smashed right through his visor. Unfortunately, his day was about to get even worse. The impact of the instantly dead bird knocked Matthew immediately unconscious, even shattering a lens of his glasses. He slumped forward on his motorcycle, inadvertently hitting the throttle. With Matthew blissfully unaware, snoozing in his seat, the bike rammed its speed up to about 225 kilometers, 140 miles per hour, before caroming off an oak tree, at an angle thankfully, and ejecting Matthew onto the road. Matthew sustained multiple rather serious injuries, including a broken leg, which required insertion of a titanium pin to correct, and not one, but two skull fractures. Nevertheless, he made a full recovery with the help of his wife, who was pregnant at the time of the accident. Thank you for watching. If you liked our video, then hit the subscribe button to never miss out on any of our videos. See you next time.